My name is Commander Sikka. What I'm going to share with you, you young lot, I'm 60 plus. Some of you will find it so useful, it will change your lives. It's up to you. But when you walk out of this place, just ponder upon it. I was born in a house which had one tin roof in the year 1958. My parents had come from Pakistan post-partition. The only thing we had in abundance was hunger. And I used to ask a question all the time to the Lord, whoever my parents believed in. Why us? Why me? For whatever reasons, I was brought up in great difficulties. I stood up in schools, graduated till the first college. I don't recall having ever worn a shirt stitched by a tailor. My mother used to wear. Such a kind of challenging life, I landed up joining Indian Navy. And that was a God's gift at that time to me. I became an officer. None in my family had ever become an officer. But soon I realized that my path, that to be a commissioned officer is not where I want to be. So I quit prematurely without pension. My parents threw a fit. How will you run your family? You have two children now. This was in 1993. I joined Piramals soon after, practically never looked back. I'm still with the Piramals. But in 1999 came Kargil War. And I found that this is an opportunity that you should pay back to society and the Navy how you're trained. So I went to Kargil Battle Theater as an embedded journalist. Difficult task. Putting your life at stake. For whatever reasons, which I don't want to explain here, I was brought down forcibly. And sitting in an army mess, I said, "You all are traitors." One officer stood up and said, "No, the traitors." I said, "Name me one," he says, "my mother." And thus started my journey calling Sehmat. Till that time, I'm a very brave man. I had the courage to go down to the battle theater, take on the enemy, write about them, write about our soldiers, did what I did, despite being a retired officer. I have guts. But here was a woman, it took me only 8 years to research on her, who spied for India, who married a Pakistani, who lived in Pakistan, who was responsible for single-handedly destroying the very brass of Pakistan, extracted out information, saved Vikrant, the aircraft carrier, and in the process was responsible for killing her own husband, father-in-law, brother-in-law, sister-in-law, and their most faithful servant. So my bravado became zero. The bubble was burst. She taught me one lesson which I'll never forget. And I would request you to think about it. She said that if nature grants you karma, there cannot be a better reward. That itself is a reward. Think about it. Today, we are buying and selling Padma Shris and Padma Awards. Today, we are willing to spend tons of money to receive some award or the other. Here was a lady who wanted to go away unsung. And she narrated me scores of saints born on this earth who have vanished away but focused on imparting education. Focus on imparting
a message. Their pictures are not there. Their message, their fragrance is around. She had said another word, that if society or nature does injustice to you, consider yourself very fortunate. Because if that happens to you, which happens to all of us all the time, consider yourself very fortunate. Because then the nature reciprocates back in its own time, but many times. So I had this strong belief in her. I spent a lot of time with her. I would ask her funny questions. I would ask her some probing questions. How did this happen? How did that happen? She would answer me for 2 minutes at max. And I would build a castle around those short little pillars that she would give, help me make. One fine day, she said that, do you have faith? I said, of course I have faith. You have faith in yourself. I said, that's the only thing I have. My history will tell you that what all I have done against everybody's wishes and odds to reach where I have reached. Today I'm president at Piramals, and which is amongst the best possible companies in the country. But at the slightest provocation, I was at Kargil Battle Theatre. So she said that, do you find that there is these cancer drugs are going out of range? That was the silence thereafter. I came back, I wrote an article in the Indian Express. It said, have some sympathy, Mr. Sinha, budgeting nightmares for cancer patients. And I went on to write a detailed article on how a finance minister of our country, a serving finance minister, Yashwant Sinha, goes abroad for his treatment free of cost, but at home he has put in 26% of additional duty on cancer drugs. The question became a star question in parliament. I was summoned. Finance minister. And he removed all the chairs in front of him. He was sitting on his desk. I was perforce asked to stand, that means politely and rudely. So I stood there and I said, it is my pent-up anguish which has converted into this article. It was not to attack you personally, but bring to your attention that this is the plight of a normal common man on the street who cannot afford 2 square meals. You ask him to pay 500, 700 rupees extra. It's not done. Point number two, I, however, stand by my article. I was asked to leave, and when I was leaving, I was mentally writing a resignation to Piramals. That was but the obvious. As I went those north block stairs, I received a message. Well done. That was from Sehmat. Just 2 days later, as if a miracle was happening, waiting to happen, Yashwant Sinha was transferred. Jaswant Singh ji came, Major Jaswant Singh. The first thing that he did, he removed all the duties on all life-saving drugs, not only cancer. And he called me and said, thank you very much for this step. He shook hands with me and I was telling myself and trying to tell him, it's somebody else's karma. I'm becoming a hero for nothing. Faith. When you tell yourself, when you put your thoughts in your mind that you are going to do it, you will do it. I asked her, I said, I want to make a film on you. She says, don't make it on me. Make it on Guru Nanak. So I said, I can afford your documentary, 5 odd crores, I can push it aside. Guru Nanak will cost me 50 crores. He says, there are two conditions here. One, you will not borrow any money. B, you will not bring the income home. The film cost us 40 crores. From A.R. Rahman to Rasool Pakuti to Pandit Jasraj, you name a celebrity, he participated in this. Kailash Kher, Sonu Nigam, singers galore, Thomas Cantilenan of the fame of Legend of Hercules, legend. You know, these from Hollywood, Bollywood, the film went to Cannes, International Film Festival, Los Angeles, Toronto, red carpeted, invited by President of India for special screening. You think of miracles, I have captured them on camera. But it was tedious, challenging task not to bring home the money. The film won 3 national awards. I went back to her. I said, somehow I have scraped through this greed business of not bringing the income home. I have still got a lot of laurels, and I really realize that it is not worth it in the end of the day. Now can I make film on you? No answer. So I said that, all right, this is around 2007 when I was planning. I said that this is a little prelude to the story. We have a gentleman called Mr. Ashwini Bhatt, who has been kidnapped. 7 days he's already away from his family. The kidnappers have taken him away. We do not know what is happening. I need help. He says, go and talk to them. Wonderful. So I landed up at Gwalior to negotiate with kidnappers. So like this light is falling on me and I cannot see you people at all. They put in the middle of the night in January some 2 jeeps in front of me, threw lights on my face. It was around 1-ish in the morning. And they said that this is our 3rd purchase, means that Ashwini Bhatt was already sold twice from one, became a product. So from one broker to the other to the final, this gentleman I was talking to. And Ashwini Bhatt was apparently part of that gang who had brought him, and they asked me, what have you got to offer? Now listen to what I had to say to them, and I can assure you, it was a spiritual effort. I told them, you have 48 hours. My man should be left unconditionally, or else none of you will see the 49th hour. I'm turning back. I'm going back to my car. If you wish to shoot, let me know. Hit me here and not at my back. They were stunned. And trust me, even I was stunned. I sat in the car. My driver drove me back. Next day, Ashwini Bhatt was released unconditionally. And he called me up and he says, Sir, kal aapne marwa diya tha. Whole night they kept telling me, asking me, questioning me, bullying me, ye sardar kaun tha. Now, what has that lady given me? She has given me a willpower by virtue of which I feel that the impossible word lies in the dictionary of maybe anybody called fools or whatever it is. It's up to you what you want to be. But what do we do to achieve that? Especially in this digital world that we have. Half the time we have the smartphone in front of us. 50% of the time in college we are spending in the canteens and chatting, chit-chatting. Or backbiting. Some will spend most of the time in dressing. Sometimes some people will spend most of the time there setting up their hair, shoes, designer shoes. You know, what Kabir Sahib wrote 900 years ago is true today. What Guru Nanak said about women, Bhand jamiye, bhand nimiye, bhando mangan vyaho, so kyu manda akhiye jit jamme rajan, means why demean her who gives birth even to the kings, and said Nanak bhando bahara eko sacha soye. If there's anybody beyond a woman who's not born to a woman, it is one eternal Lord. Where are we today? India's largest female infanticide is in Punjab. We don't believe in religion, caste, creed. We want money. We demean women at this. We have not allowed them to go anywhere, not even Sabarimala. US doesn't have a lady president. A lady, a woman's stature, according to Guru Nanak, was higher than that of a man. We made him a Sikh. And said that Guru Nanak's film cannot be screened in the halls. So we put it on digital fora, iTunes, Google Play. A.R. Rahman said this matches the scale of Lawrence of Arabia. He spoke on Amazon Prime Video, you can see that. So what is it that you ultimately wish to go for? Focus. And not outwardly. You have to focus within yourself. What is it that we all are born with, that little fire? We do not allow it to go up. Some of us do. But majority of us, you know, we just follow the long queue in front. It's up to us what you want to do. A girl in St. Teresa's College, Kochi, I've addressed about 10,000 students in various schools and colleges. She said, I want to do a dissertation on, present a dissertation on calling Sehmat. So I went to Kochi to meet her and said, what is in your dream? What do you want to do? She said, I want to be Mother Teresa. Now, who's stopping you? Your young minds. At any age, at any stage of your life, you have a Sehmat in you. I can count the impossible looking incidents in my life, and you will realize that it happened because there was a faith. She had also said that all the religions put together are part of fraudsters and scamsters and thugs. That religions that take you nowhere except to the goons. You want to connect to the Lord, be spiritual. This is a dhanda that these people are carrying out, religions. And she was a Muslim, Kashmiri Muslim woman. So what have we done in return as a country? We have spent 8,000 crores every year in the valley to stop terrorism. However, we have actually promoted terrorism. This 8,000 crore has been funding all kinds of separatists. Has it ever dawned on us that none of these separatists have any source of income, but their children study overseas? So we have never questioned the government. After government have had a ball, the paramilitary forces have had a ball. They still, now some past few years it has been cut down dramatically. But when a mother loses her child, be it Muslim, Hindu, Christian, ask that woman what it goes into her mind, into her heart. So if you have faith within you, if you have energy within you, which we all have, if you have guts in you, which we all have, then you do not need money. The money needs you. That is Sehmat. And when I walk away from this place, I want you all to ponder upon yourselves. Just tickle your minds and hearts a little bit. Thank you so much.